Welcome to the Master Info Week of the Università della Svizzera Italiana. For the whole week, you will find useful resources such as a welcome from our rector, Professor Boaz Eretz, a campus tour, testimonials from both current students and alumni, and an overview of UZI's graduates' placement opportunities. You can watch a brief description of our students' services and a useful tutorial on how to fill the online application form. Now, you're about to attend a thorough presentation of the master structure and contents. You can ask us any question, academic or administrative related, through the chat below this video or through the form at the bottom of the page. After the presentation, we will answer all your questions during a live session with the director of the program. Thank you and enjoy.
Welcome to Switzerland, welcome to Lugano, welcome to the Artificial Intelligence Master offered by Università della Svizzera Italiana. I'm Luca Gambardella, the Master Director. Artificial intelligence is one of the most popular areas in computer science and engineering today. AI is a way to solve problems, taking inspiration from the way people sense, reason, take actions, learn and adapt to unknown situations. AI today is everywhere, is in your watch, in your smartphone, and in many computing programs that you use every day. There is also an important point related to artificial intelligence because big players are investing a lot of money in artificial intelligence, and also the job market related to artificial intelligence is growing very fast. The Master in Artificial Intelligence we offer in Lugano is the first AI program in Switzerland and is profiting from the competence from the Faculty of Informatics and from Dalle-Molle Institute for Artificial Intelligence, a common institute with SUPSI and one of the world leading research institutes in this field. ITSE was founded in 1988, more than 30 years ago, and now has 90 people, 9 professors, 50 postdocs, and 20 PhD students. What are the objectives and the context of the master? I really see artificial intelligence a little bit as an umbrella term, and inside this umbrella term, we focus your knowledge, we want to deep your knowledge in area like machine learning, deep learning, and also we teach you how to treat data and to extract knowledge from the data with data science. But we do not forget that at the end you must also be able to program this algorithm in a very effective way. Other two nice areas are computer vision and data warehouse that are really crucial in this moment for artificial intelligence, and we also have the opportunity to give a robotic course inside a very well-equipped robotic lab. In relation to labs, I mentioned that also we have the deep learning lab full of GPUs where you really can practice state-of-the-art methodology and tools related to deep learning and reinforcement learning. What about the courses? The master is divided in 4 semesters and the courses are divided in 2 groups. One are the mandatory course and the other one are the elective. The mandatory are really needed to deepen your knowledge in the AI, but you also have the right and the chance to take some way the path that you prefer in choosing some courses that are close to artificial intelligence. BAC, there are something like blockchain, advanced topic in machine learning, and mobile and wearable computing. Then something that is close to AI, but you can organize your curricula in a more independent way. The first semester we give the machine learning course, that is one of the most important course in this master, and in parallel we give the deep learning lab where as I told you, you can practice some methodology. But do not forget you are a computer scientist, then we have also to understand algorithm complexity and something about numerical analysis. For the machine learning course, we have the privilege here to have one of the most famous scientists in this area. It is Jürgen Schmidhuber. He is the inventor of LSTM, long short-term memory, that was invented here in Lugano in 1997. LSTM, I think, is one of the most used methodology in deep learning now, not in academia, but in very, very large companies. The next semester, we start the second semester, you start to treat data. We have the data analytics course, but also you start to understand what are stochastic methodology, and it's time to do the robotic course. For robotics, I tell you that we are in a very good network in Switzerland, because this is the logo of the Swiss National Center of Competence in Robotics from the Swiss National Science Foundation. And if you see, in Switzerland there are three pillars. Two are the two polytechs, but the third pillar is here in Lugano. And I want you to listen what people in Boston think about us and about our robotic and drone activities.
Welcome to Tech Talk and to our special SwissNext series. Every month, we travel around the world together with SwissNext to bring you the latest on innovation and technology. And the next stop on our tour is Boston, that recently hosted Aerial Futures, the Drone Frontier, connecting Switzerland with the US using, you guessed it, drones. Francesco Bortoluzzi, project coordinator for SwissNext Boston, joined us from the CNN studios in New York to tell us more.
We've tried to really bring the drone ecosystem from Switzerland to North America and the other way around, too, to really spark open international conversations on the future of drone technology and applications. Arts.
And of course, in Switzerland, we are very aware and actually really pride ourselves here on being home to more or less 80 startups. Drone-related startups, as well as home to Drone Valley, which is, you know, what this wonderful space between major players like ETH and EPFL. So did you find that this was also reflected in the US participants? I mean, did they also, what was the perception? How did they perceive the Swiss technology?
Well, they perceived the Swiss technology as being really high tech and being really very developed and very useful and having very interesting applications. But I should say about the Drone Valley, as you say, it's not just between Zurich and Lausanne. It's also between Lausanne, Zurich, and Lugano, because we have a robotics AI lab in Ticino. And as we put together our Aerial Futures program, we were very careful in selecting companies and research institutions from all the three major Swiss linguistic regions to really showcase Switzerland as a whole to the American public.
I have to say, I'm very happy that you also brought Lugano into the conversation.
I have nothing to add here. I'm talking about the third semester. The third semester we have the artificial intelligence course where we also learn and understand how to solve complex problem using meta heuristics. But we also practice distributed algorithm, a crucial area here, because to solve AI problem today, you in some case you need GPUs, but maybe you also need cloud computing, distributed computing, then you need to understand very well this area. I do a little bit of self-promotion now, because I am the professor, the teacher of the artificial intelligence course. I've been director of Dalemolle Institute for 25 years, and I am one of the pioneers of ant colony optimization meta heuristics and swarm intelligence since 1994. In the fourth semester, we cover these two topics I mentioned before. One is computer vision and pattern recognition, but we do not also forget the geometric deep learning, a really, really growing area in AI, and we want to tell you something about that. You also have the chance to finish your thesis. Your thesis was started a little bit in the third semester, but you are going to complete it in the first semester. But in relation to the elective course, I want to tell you something about a new elective course we started last year. It is in conjunction with the the Master in Philosophy of the university, and is given by half by an AI professor, half by a philosopher, a professor in philosophy, and we really treat the topic about humans, human brain, the brain of the computer, but also we take care about privacy, data protection, how to put human in the center also in this moment where AI is growing so fast. In relation to your thesis, I mentioned that in many cases your thesis is a thesis that is related to a research project or an applied project. And I let you see now this video where we really teach a drone to follow a trail in the forest without any prior knowledge, only by showing the drone how it's possible, how a person is following the trail, is following the trail with while he's walking.
In this research, we design a controller to make a quadcopter follow forest trails autonomously. These trails are used by hikers and mountain bikers, and this trail-following technology allows the quadcopter to quickly explore a wilderness area for search and rescue operations. The robot is equipped with a forward-looking color camera, which is its only sensor for navigation. Discerning these trails directly from camera images is an extremely difficult pattern recognition problem, which is also challenging for humans. In the images you see here, it is not at all trivial to determine which direction the trail goes. To solve the navigation problem, we designed an image classifier that takes an image as input and returns one of three classes indicating whether a trail is visible on the left side of the image, in the center of the image, or on the right side of the image. When the robot is on the trail, our controller applies the classifier to the image acquired by its camera and steers the robot in the corresponding direction in order to remain on the trail. The classifier is implemented using a state-of-the-art deep neural network with 10 layers, 150,000 weights, 500,000 neurons, and 57 million connections. Such a powerful classifier must be trained on a large data set of images, and for each image on the data set, it must be known whether the trail is to the left, in the center, or on the right. In order to acquire this labeled data set efficiently, we equipped a hiker with three head-mounted GoPro cameras, one pointing left, one pointing straight ahead, and one pointing right. Video was taken while hiking several different trails in the Swiss Alps, with the hiker taking care to consistently point his head in the direction he was walking. Each of the three cameras mounted on the hiker's head acquires images belonging to a particular class. The images taken from the camera pointing straight ahead have the trail in the center of the image. Images taken from the camera on the left have the trail to the right, and the images taken from the camera on the right have the trail on the left side. Using this procedure, we quickly acquired more than 20,000 images correctly labeled for our three classes. These images were used to train the classifier. The following experiments were performed on several alpine trails, different from those used to generate the training set. The custom-built quadcopter is equipped with an onboard Odroid computer, which runs the entire video processing and control system. In the videos you see, the AR drone navigates a mountain trail without any human guidance, purely using the information obtained from its camera. As you can see, the deep neural network classifier provides excellent information that lets the quadcopter safely navigate a variety of trails that it has never seen before.
Yes, this was a very challenging research project, but if after the master you want to continue your career, maybe your academic career doing a PhD, I want to remind you that one of the three founders of DeepMind, Shane Lack, did his PhD in USI in Lugano. Then maybe you take inspiration from his career and you do something similar. Then I think it's clear to you now that really the way and the reason that you have to come to Lugano to follow the AI course is also because in Lugano we have really an ecosystem around artificial intelligence. Remember, Switzerland is the most innovative country in worldwide, and in Lugano we also have Lugano Living Lab, then the city of Lugano is very active in artificial intelligence and digitalization. We have companies where you can maybe continue your career. We have also startup acceleration. And I want to show you what was possible to do with the city of Lugano last year. We create an artistic installation inside a very long tunnel in the city, and the artistic installation is a big neural network working in real time, recognizing your gesture. But I show you the video. Then if you come to Lugano, please by train, mainly do not forget to go below the train station and to see Neural Rope, this very huge installation. And I also want to show you another artistic experience we did with a group of dancers in Lugano. We teach a drone to follow the head of the dancer, and I show you the video now. I stop here, but the video was taken inside our drone arena. I want to go toward the conclusion, tell you that the AI market is growing, and also the job market related to artificial intelligence is really growing fast. And the area that companies are really looking for are exactly the area where we focus our master: machine learning, data scientists, computer vision, and algorithm. And before concluding, I mentioned that the Dalemol Institute was awarded by the CEO of NVIDIA in 2016 as one of the pioneers in AI research. And if you see the slide, there is Berkeley, Carnegie Mellon, Qatar, MIT, New York, Stanford, University of Montreal, Oxford, there is ITSIA, and also Toronto. And the prize arrived with a very big computer of under $30,000. I conclude my presentation telling that If you want to apply, you can apply also online to the master. We have two deadlines. One is the 34th of master of May for people that need a visa, but we wait until the 34th of August for people that does not need a visa. In this coronavirus period, we also increase the number of scholarships that maybe you have the chance to get a scholarship and to you know to help you to come to Lugano to have your master. I conclude. I say to you hello, and I hope to see you very soon in Lugano for the artificial intelligence master. Bye bye.
Welcome back. Thanks for watching this online session. Professor Gambardella presented in depth the Master in Artificial Intelligence, and he joined us here in order to answer all the questions you sent us. So let's start right away. We got a few questions on the chat. The first one is from Jonathan. He said, good afternoon. I'm still undecided between the master in computational science and artificial intelligence. Can you help me understanding the main differences? Why should I choose AI instead of computational science? And he added that he knows that it's a personal decision, but any hint is appreciated. Luca, what do you have to say?
Yes, hello to everybody from Lugano. Yeah, I mean, there is a main difference, I think, between the two masters. The computational science is more mathematics, simulation, and maybe related to natural problem like DNA foldings and so on. AI maybe is more general. We talk about data science, robotics, machine learning, and from my perspective, also the career path is strongly different because AI already opened a vast number of possibility in the market after.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, thanks, Professor. Now, Andrea asks us, do you need a language certificate? Do I need a language certificate even if my bachelor studies were in English? If yes, what's the deadline? TOEFL sessions have very limited availability. So I can answer this, I will answer this. For students who got their bachelor degree in English, entirely in English, no other language certificates are needed. So you can apply and you will be evaluated even if you don't attach any English certificate. But keep in mind that your bachelor degree must be entirely taught in English. And this it must be, you know, readable and must be seen from your academic transcript. For the second part of your question, it's true, TOEFL sessions and or exam session are very limited in this COVID-19 situation right now. For those who need to take a test, which is not your case, we postpone the deadlines, so we will check if you are not already, you know, if you have not already taken the test, we will assess your English level in September, and we will give you time and up to the end of the year to show us that you reach the level and you got the certification you need. Now, Sasha, I've read that the faculty will move to a new campus. Will you have laboratories to work and study in? How much is the master practical? So Luca, from the second part of the question, maybe if you can say something about the campus as well.
Yeah. The campus is more or less ready. We plan to move at the beginning of the semester or maybe some months later due to the coronavirus. We have some delay there. But I mean, I think there is a good point there, because also the Dalle-Molle Institute is going to merge in the campus and the robotic lab is going to be there. Then for sure we have the opportunity also to meet our 20 PhD students of Izia, 90 colleagues of us, then I think the focus and the center of AI is going to be in the new campus for the entire canton. Yes, it's a great opportunity.
Okay, perfect. So you answered another question together with this, the question that we received through the online form, which was a request of clarification of what kind of interaction there is between UZI master's degree students and the ITSEA researchers and staff and faculty. I think you already said something. If you want to,
I can add more. I mean, the whole history is 90 people, and we have 50 researchers. Many of the professors of the master come from ITSEA, then Richmond Tuber, myself, Giusti, we have the robotic teacher. Then we have many, you know, interaction between Dalai Lama Institute and I think one of the most important point, you have the chance to make the master thesis with ITSEA people. Then I think to be closer in the new campus is also something that is very useful and very, very attractive for the master student coming.
Thank you. Again, with a question from Elizabeth. And is a bachelor in informatics the only one considered for admission, or is a background in natural sciences, physics, or math valid?
No, we have students coming from different paths, from computer science for sure, but we have students coming from math, from physics, from other disciplines. We require a background in computer science, then that we check your courses. If you had courses in computer science, it's fine. Otherwise, we give you some debit to cover. But usually, people coming from engineer, physics, and math, we accept them without a large number of debits, usually without.
Okay, we got another question from the web form about more or less the same topics. It's Tristano, who has a background in theoretical physics, asking with this background if you have any hints or suggestions about which kind of courses or class he can take in order to be ready for without any gap by the beginning of the term in September. If you have any suggestion, Professor Gambardella, they are very welcome, or maybe there's a chance to attend courses, basic courses in informatics here at the faculty in Lugano?
Yeah, first I want to tell you that the best machine learning and AI people as your background, then you must start in a good position. Then if you need to recover some computer science course, you can do them here, you can do them offline, but We prefer that you maybe take this course here, because in some way we prefer to certificate the course through our university. In some case, you have already background, because we met people that already did a lot of programming before coming, maybe in a company, maybe for the thesis, maybe we usually find a way to compensate in case you need some more knowledge, but don't worry, your background is perfect for AI.
Thanks a lot, Professor. Now I will go through the questions of Tristano. There are a few, because two of these I should, we will answer in a separate communication, because the other comics, which is a graduate school we have here at UZI in computational science, and is asking whether it will be available to first year master students. We need to check this with the director and of the computational science master and the director of the Institute of Computer of Computational Science. So I will, we will answer you in the coming days. About the third question from Tristano, if the blockchain's protocol and techniques for distributed trust is a course that will be available for next academic year, it's an elective for AI. I need to double check this before an answer with the director of the Financial Technology and Computing Master, which is which this course is a core part of. So again, the answer will come later. And then the last question from Tristano is, given the situation with the current pandemic, has this delayed the expected completion date of the East Campus? Professor Gambardella already mentioned it a little bit. There are several entities that are going to, you know, move to this new East Campus, that it's a new development of our university, where the Faculty of Informatics, ITSIA, so the Institute of Robotics here in Lugano will move, some laboratories and parts of SUPSI, and the Faculty of Biomedical Sciences. Of course, this pandemic has slowed down the completion of the campus, which is almost over, almost complete. Part of the Faculty of Biomedical Sciences will probably move in September, October, and the Faculty of Informatics and hence the Master in AI will move within the first semester. So it's probably, it's gonna be October or maybe December after the end of the first term. This is something we are still looking into. We are you know, easing the lockdown restrictions during these days here in Switzerland. So construction is has started over already, and there needs to be an assessment of what is going to happen. So we don't have a definite answer right now. Let's go on with questions from the chat, because we received more. Davide is asking, good afternoon. Is a minimum vote in the bachelor required to sign up in the Master of Artificial Intelligence? Luca, will you answer, please?
No, it isn't. Then, if you are eligible in terms of background, or in terms of type of bachelor, we do not have any restriction on that.
Okay. And again, Davide is asking another question, which you mentioned partially before, is if this master is mainly focused on theoretical studies or on practical applications?
I think there is a mix in the master, because you need to know some machine learning, and in machine learning you need to know some statistics. Then you have to know the theory, but we also have course in algorithm and complexity, because we understand that for an AI person is important to understand how complex is a problem before starting to code and to solve it. But we have also many, many practical activities. We have a deep learning lab, we have a robotic lab. In my course of meta heuristic, we also practice some algorithm. Then I think it's a good mix, because you need to have theory, you need to have practice, and you know, we are in the field since 30 years, and we know what is needed now for computer scientists taking the AI master. And we really prepare the master in a way that you can really go working with a good knowledge.
Okay, now we have another question that was sent in with the online form. And it's from Jan. And this question: I know this master is quite young in the form it's offered now, but do you already have graduated students? And if yes, what are they doing, and how they are they, you know, starting their job career?
Do you have some news? Yes, of course. Yes, I mean, Just to remind you, this is the first AI master in Switzerland. Then we have been the first, and we have already some people with, that graduates. Some is doing a PhD. One is doing the PhD in Groningen in artificial intelligence. We have graduated that are working as applied scientists in Seattle for Amazon. We have people doing machine learning engineer in Zurich. We have people still in Zurich at UBS making working there. We also have good AI company here in Ticino, and we have people now that now started to go to work for our, if you like, AI companies. I mean, I think it's a mix because we have people moving to academia, people moving to industry, but I mean, always with the AI job, data science. We are very happy for these first results.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, let me see whether we have more questions. No, I think that we answered all the questions on the chat. We are receiving several others slowly through the form, but those are questions that needs to be addressed specifically. So I think that if in case, you know, Professor Gambardella, if you have something else you want to add specifically,
yeah, maybe, yes? Yeah, maybe I have a point. We have also students doing a double degree here. Then we offer also for with some other university the possibility to have a double degree. Then, okay, this is an option that you can maybe evaluate in your career path.
Okay, perfect. So I think it's all for this session. Please keep sending us your questions through the form at the bottom of this page. The chat is going to be disabled at the end of this live session, but the form will stay there. Send in questions, and we will answer throughout the whole week and even after that. For all general questions and questions related to housing deadlines, I will answer together with my colleagues from the Study Advisory Service. For all the questions academic related, I will forward the questions to Professor Gambardella, and he will be very happy to answer you and to help you out. I hope this session was helpful for you and in order to help you out decide or better understand what is that you are going to choose or what will be or could be your potential next academic challenge. I thank Professor Gambardella for being with us.
Thank you very much. So remember, AI is not only the present, it's also the future. Then be ready for AI in your career.
Awesome. Thanks a lot. And this is it. And goodbye.
Goodbye.